Thank you very much for being here, and thank you, Excellencies and ladies and gentlemen. I'm chairman of the board for Royal Arctic Line, as he told you. I'm appointed by the government of Greenland, and I would like to talk about our projects in Royal Arctic Line and what we are doing about changing and the turnaround of the company, because change is inevitable and necessary as we see it. And Greenland needs to implement reforms. We can do that in many ways, in my view. We can do that by turning around our companies and see how we can make them more efficient. And we can also do that by doing politics, but this is not my area at the moment. But anyways, I'm trying to do everything I can with the company that we have in hand here to help in developing Greenland. And also, in that sense, I would urge our stakeholders to stand together, because we are doing this for a higher purpose, and the higher purpose is for Greenland, and also our neighbors, for making economics of scale. I would say that we have seen the proof. Shipping infrastructure drives growth. There's a little history here that I saw, which is very important and admirable in my view. That is, Eimskip was established in 1914, and here in 2016 we are in the blink of making a joint venture with Eimskip, and that could create history, the future history for Greenland, because the infrastructure in that sense could give us better opportunities business-wise. In my view, partnerships lead to success if we do it right. And at the moment, I feel very pleased to see that our companies are cooperating within all the goods of, and a very good example on how you cooperate and make partnerships. We will try to form our future together, and I will say that this is only the beginning of the start. In my view, you could go all the way in the right now, but I think we also have to take the necessary measures to have everybody with us, so we get gradual organic growth and not over to the extremes. A very short presentation of Royal Arctic Line. For those of you who don't know Royal Arctic Line, Royal Arctic Line is 100% owned by the government of Greenland. We employ about 700 people in Greenland and Denmark. Our revenue is about $125 million in 2015. Net result, $14 million in 2015. And our vision in Royal Arctic Line is that we would like to make it easy to do businesses in Greenland. And I will tell you a little bit about that right now. Oh. This is what we do best, special operations. There's a new harbor being built. It will be ready hopefully in February next year. And this will be create the primary hub for Greenland. At the moment, we are using the harbor in Aalborg as our primary harbor, but this will, in my view, change in the future. At the moment, we connect Greenland with Denmark with a few connections to Reykjavik, but we will also change that in the future. where we will, in cooperation, see if we can port Norway, Sweden, Poland, Denmark, and also connect to the rest of Europe through UK, Rotterdam, and Hamburg, and towards our export markets to Asia and the States and Canada, and so forth. We would like to create jobs and higher value of our export goods, and I believe that if we reform, if we turn around our company, we can create possibilities for businesses for adding more value to in Greenland, and we can have more direct and faster lead times to our markets, because in Greenland we import almost everything. Our 97% of our value in exports are fish and shrimp. So I would urge companies to proactively make strategies to improve supply chain and planning and transformation of their companies to these new possibilities. They could look at operational improvements, facility rationalization, inventory management, technology planning and implementation, outsourcing, benchmarking against, like we are benchmarking against Maersk Line, even though they are the world's biggest, but we have to benchmark somebody. They can look at warehousing and also, nonetheless, the transportation that we could provide. This is happening. I'm very pleased to see that our work towards a joint venture is materializing, and I really hope that we can have some information for you in the near future. Thank you very much.